Welcome to online teaching. Today we will discuss chapter 5th of geography of class 10th, minerals and energy resources. This is module 1. Now in this we will discuss about the minerals. You can see from a safety pin to aeroplane, train, buses, the vehicles, the things that we are using in our daily life, all are related to minerals. You may say that from gold, silver to talcum powder, the Colgate, the brushes, the things that we are using in our daily life, all are related to minerals. You have also read in science that minerals are the essential components for the human beings. They are only 0.03%, but even then they are very important for the human beings. You can see that what things we are having, we need calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, iron and many more minerals that are required. All these are found into the fruits, vegetables, dry fruits, maximum things that we are having. Okay, now minerals, you know they are very important. Now we will see about the definition. These are the substances that is homogeneous, having a definite or definable internal structure. You can see that these are found into the raw form. Iron ore is there, gold is there, silver is there. They are embedded, they are covered into the form of rocks, that may be into the solid form, liquid form, or that may be, you may say, even gaseous form. All are the part of the minerals. Okay, now next thing is there that we will be discussing, the geographers and geologists. These are two persons responsible for evaluation or for extraction or for studying about these minerals. Geographers and geologists. Geographers, they study about the minerals that are found, yeah, the things that are found outside the crust, means the upper part of the crust. And geologists, that are, these are means the upper part of earth, related to geographers, and inside the crust. They study about these layers of the earth, and maximum these minerals that are found inside the earth, deep inside also. Some things that are found into the upper part like soil is there, that is also a mineral that the agriculture is practiced. Different components are also the part of these minerals that are found into the soil. Okay, now next thing is there, you have studied about the metals, yeah, metallic or non-metallic. These are also two minerals or form of minerals that are found. It is very clear here that the component of iron, means metallic, is there, that something iron is found. In that the iron is found, that is totally related to the metallic. Okay, now in this categorization of metal, what is there? This is the metallic form. And what is in this? Ferrous and non-ferrous. These are the two things that are found, ferrous and non-ferrous. It is very clear here from, that is example like iron. Maximum thing is there that some iron component, iron part is found, that is known as ferrous. And means known is there that may be in the form of mica is there, aluminium is there, that are formed into the form of even gold and silver, that are the form of non-ferrous, means no quantity of the iron. Okay, here you can frame the differences. Ferrous means iron component, absence of iron component. Example can be formed iron ore. Here the example mica, aluminium, and these are used in metallurgical or heavy iron industries. These are used into the form of light form electrical and electronic industries, that is also found. Okay, even in some of the electric and electronic both, but they are a little, no such component of iron is found. Okay, and here another is, that is non-metallic, totally nothing is there of the iron, like sulfur, sodium is there, you have read, sodium is there. These are the known metals that are found. Where no such of iron is found, that is non-metallic. Okay, these are about the minerals. Now second thing is energy resources. Energy, you have read the force, that everything, that is the part, you know that energy can't be wasted, it can be converted into one form to the another form. Okay, here what I mean, energy resources are there, you have read about renewable, you have also read about non-renewable. Okay, and here what will be that, that will be conventional. That will be non-conventional and that will be conventional. Renewable resources are there that cannot, that can be renewed. That can be renewed, okay? Non-renewable that cannot be renewed. You have read about the solar energy is there, the wind energy is there, and geothermal energy is there. That means that can be renewed. Water is there. That can be, you may say, come into existence again. And non-renewable, it means if they are extinct, it is impossible to come again, like fossil fuels are there. Okay? Conventional means these are the, the form of that coal and petrol. Coal, petroleum, all are the part of what? Non-conventional. Here, the solar energy, the wind energy, that can be converted into foam. Okay, it means what will be there, you can frame the differences. These can be renewed, these can be made again, these cannot be made again. It second is, they are eco-friendly, they are not eco-friendly. Okay, and example can be solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy. Here the fossil fuels that will be included. Here what will be there, their lifetime, or you may, their formation of our existence, that is more, and it is means their time period, we may say, that is more. Here it time period is limited. Okay, another can also be framed from here, that it takes you may say short period of time, and it takes millions of years for their formation. You can see the fossil fuel are there, if they are extinct, they will take millions of years for their formation, and it is very easy. Okay, in that their starting cost is more, and after that it is very easy to use. Here their cost is very, you may say, they are expensive from the beginning. You can frame the differences very easily. These are very important things. Two things we have discussed about minerals and energy resources. Minerals, these are the substances with a homogeneous structure, with a definite or definable structure. Example, you can frame iron ore is there, and even the rocks are there that are covered, the coal is found, the petroleum is found, the gases are found. Okay, and energy resources, these are the, some are that eco-friendly, some are, you may say, that can pollute the environment. Okay, two things we have discussed. Okay, we will discuss more in next module.